President Lenin Moreno confirmed that a number of state institutions will be eliminated, leaving just 20 ministries. The government also confirmed the increase in the price of premium fuel.
The subsidies must benefit those who have less and not those who have. That is why we are aiming for super petrol, which is linked to a segment of the population that has high-end vehicles and can absorb this update on the price.
According to the government, fuel subsidies cost Ecuador more than $3 billion. This is why a national dialogue will take place. However, several social groups have rejected this measure. This is concern about the future of small farming companies.
We reject the measures adopted by the government and the increase of fuel. These are recipes of the International Monetary Fund that affect the poorest directly.
On the other hand, the economic measures are triggering mixed reactions from the Ecuadorian people.
I believe that it is a negative measure for the country. The president says that it will not affect the lower class, but it even affects the medium class. Because when the petrol is increased, cost of transport and food also increases, and this affects everyone.
The government also says that it has uncovered corruption in Panama and the U.S. and is working to return the money to the country. According to the government, this will bring more than $1,000 million per year in savings. Denise Herrera, Telesur, Ecuador.